Difference. My name is Anne, and we are going to continue our series that's called Rooted. Last week, if you were here with us for our very first episode, we started in this series talking about how we are rooted in the reality of the resurrection. And we talked about how proof of the resurrection, evidence of the resurrection, is actually found in your story and my story. And today, what we're going to talk about is, okay, if you believe that the resurrection was true, if you believe that Jesus was who he says he was and is who he says he is, and that he went to the cross to forgive your sins and my sins, and that there's nothing that we can do on our own to get out of that sin that we are in, and you believe and you make that commitment, but then what happens next? So we go from being rooted in the reality of the resurrection to being rooted in a relationship with God. You know, sometimes I think as believers, we think, oh, I've made this commitment to Jesus, and I've said yes to a life with him, and now I'm all good. Like, it's a transaction that we just make, and it's a one-time transaction, and we get there, and then we get eternal life with him is our reward. But this is not a transaction. This is a beginning to a relationship. When you say yes to Jesus, when you make a commitment to Jesus, it's the start of a lifelong relationship. And it's not just that one day you will have a great eternal life in heaven, but it actually is that every single day, right now in your life, you can have that relationship with him. So what does that look like? What does that look like to have a relationship with God? You know, the interesting thing is that in 2020, the pandemic revealed a lot about our relationships with Christ. Some people, when the pandemic hit and churches were closed, they didn't know what to do because their relationship was simply based around an hour a week or a couple of hours a month when they encountered God in their church service. But then for some of us, the pandemic hit and we're like, okay, we still have a relationship with God because my relationship with God is not dependent on a time of the week or a time of the month or a specific place. I can continue to have that relationship with God. So one of the ways that I look at this is it's kind of like someone gets married for the very first time, okay? And they make this commitment to this other person, and they say, okay, I commit to living with you forever. They go down the aisle. They say, I do. And then when they're walking away and they meet in the foyer of the church, it's like one of them says to the other, you know, this is so great. I really long to be married to you. I really want this commitment, but I'm going to need to fit you into my schedule the way that it is. So, you know, if I have time at the end of the day, or maybe once a week for an hour we can get together, or maybe a couple of times a month, but that's really all I have time for. I don't know about you, but I don't think that would be the best way to start a marriage relationship. And I also don't think that's the healthiest way to start and continue our relationship with the Father. And so what do we do about that? How do we root ourselves in a healthy relationship with our Heavenly Father? Well, actually, what we're going to do is we're going to go to Mark chapter 1, verses 35 through 37, and we're going to look at what Jesus did. Because Jesus is our example. Here at the chapel, we talk all the time about becoming more like Jesus for the sake of others. So let's see what Jesus did to have a healthy relationship with his Father. So let's go to Mark chapter 1, verses 35 through 37, and this is what it says. Before daybreak the next morning, Jesus got up and went out to an isolated place to pray. Later, Simon and the others went out to find him. When they found him, they said, "Everyone is looking for you." We're just going to stop there because I think there's so much for us to unpack just in those few short verses. And what I want to do is look at a couple of important things that Jesus did there. The first one is this: before daybreak, before daybreak. Now, some of you guys are already sighing and rolling your eyes, and you're saying, "And I am not a morning person." But here's the interesting thing. Whatever you think about first in your day, whatever you put in your mind first thing is what anchors your day. So how do you want to anchor your day? Do you want it to be anchored in, you know, the news and the chaos of what's going on in the world? Do you want it to be anchored in the chaos that may be going on in your house? Do you want it to be anchored in your emails and your text messages? How you begin your day anchors your day. I want to begin my day in the Word of God, listening to Him and praying to Him, because I want that to be something that I experience the whole rest of the day. I want the thoughts that are going through my mind to really anchor and solidify all of the decisions and all of the rest of the thoughts that I have for the rest of that day. And here's another reason that before daybreak, early in the morning, is really important. So I look at it kind of like I do with giving to the church, tithing, okay? A lot of times people will say, well, whatever I have left over at the end of the month, then I'll give that to God. I'll give that to the church. And we do the same thing sometimes with our time. We say, well, you know, I'm so busy and, you know, whatever I have left over at the end of the day, then I'll spend some time in prayer. Or I'll spend some time in meditation. Well, just like when I do that with my money, when I say, yeah, God, I'll give you whatever is left over at the end of the month. I don't know about you, but there is never anything left over at the end of the month when I do that. And if I do that with my time, there is never time at the end of the day when I do that with my time. I end up filling my day with all kinds of other things, and then there are still things that I need to get done before I go to bed, and I find that my head hits the pillow, and I'm not sleeping, and I'm not praying, and all these things are wandering kind of through my mind, and yet I don't have time to spend with God in His Word. And so before daybreak is critical. It's key. And I know that some of you guys are not morning people. I don't know. Maybe Jesus wasn't even a morning person. We don't know. But He put His Father first because He knew whatever He put in His mind at the early part of the day anchored His day. So there's before daybreak. And then Jesus got up and went out. That is really important. Sometimes I've tried to start my time with God in the morning, and I put my, all of my stuff that I need by my bedside, and I'll grab my Bible and maybe a journal or something like that. And if it is before daybreak, you know what I end up doing? Falling back asleep. Maybe that's happened to you as well. So that's why it's important to get up and go out. So get up from your bed. Go out into another room, grab a cup of coffee. That is very important for me. Grab a cup of coffee, get everything that you need. I go ahead and take my vitamins too, and get everything that I need to start the day. And then I go into that quiet time when my brain is awake and I'm ready to be focused on Him. But you've got to get up early and in order to anchor your day in the truth of God's Word, and then get up and go out. Go to that one place where you can really connect with God. And then the third thing that I want for us to pay attention to is it says in verse 35, he went out to an isolated place to pray. So he went away and kind of sequestered himself from all of the rest of the rumblings in the morning and all of the rest of the busyness. And what did he do when he got there? He spent time in prayer. Now, some of you guys may be really intimidated by the thought of prayer. Prayer is simply an honest conversation between yourself and the Father. You can talk to the Heavenly Father just like I'm talking to you. You can talk to Him just like you talk to a friend. You can talk to Him about anything. There's no special word. There's no special script. But the thing that I want to encourage you to do is not just talk to Him, But a conversation involves speaking and listening. How are you listening to the Father? Because, yes, He wants to hear from you, but He also wants to speak to your heart. He wants to speak to your soul. He wants to fill you up with the truth from His Word. So one of the ways that we can listen as we have this conversation is we can read His words that are found in the Bible. We can read His truths, and that's how we listen to Him. So Jesus got up early in the morning. He got up out of his bed, out of his house even, and found a quiet place, and then He spent time with the Father. So what about you? Are you ready to start down that road of having a personal relationship where you and the Father have a connection? Here's the difference when we spend time with the Father. It's time with God connects your heart to His heart. That's what spending time with God does. So if you're saying, yes, I'm ready to do that, I don't want my relationship with God just to be a transaction, I want it to be a relationship. Where do I start? Well, I'm so glad you asked. Because this week in our chapel online group, we're actually going to be focused on providing you guys with some resources and some places for you to get started. So one of the places that I encourage you to get started is by praying and reading the book of John. Just start right at the beginning in John chapter 1 and read just maybe a chapter a day, or if you want to read just even shorter sections a day, and begin kind of writing out some things that stand out to you. Maybe some verses that you want to remember, or maybe some thoughts that kind of come to mind, and write out some of your prayers. And then just keep a journal of the things that you feel like Jesus is saying to you through His Word. Another thing that you can do to get started is to go to the YouVersion app. So this is a great Bible app that not only has different translations of the Bible that you can use, but it also has a ton of different devotionals that you can go through with passages of Scripture and prayer, sometimes even music, all of these, sometimes video. And these are great ways to get started in your relationship with God. But some of you guys may have already been going with a personal time with God. But maybe from time to time you get stuck. Has that ever happened to you? Where you kind of approach your quiet time with God, your personal time with Him, and it's kind of just like a thing that you just check off during the day. Yep, I did that. I checked it off. I prayed and I read Scripture. And sometimes it becomes more about a head knowledge than a heart knowledge. Sometimes it becomes more about a have-to than a get-to. So for those of us who might find ourselves kind of stuck, here's what I encourage you to do. Change things up a little bit. If you're not journaling, then start journaling. If you're not praying kind of like intercessory prayers for other people, begin praying intercessory prayers for other people. If you find yourself just kind of reading Scripture and it not really, you know, speaking to your soul, try a new translation. Try a new Bible study resource that we're going to be posting in the Chapel Online group. There are so many great ways for you to connect with God and for His heart to connect with your heart. So I look forward to sharing those tools with you this week and for all of us to work on having a healthy, loving relationship.